Good afternoon and welcome to Tubby Raymond Field here at the University of Delaware Stadium. It is Fighting Blue Hens Lacrosse on this Saturday afternoon as they welcome in Villanova for their annual showdown alongside Tyler Morrell. I'm Andrew Bogish. Thanks for being with us. Hopefully you are inside and warm on a rare actual winter day here in the Mid-Atlantic. It's been a very mild winter to say the least, but today temperature's technically about 32, 33 degrees right now, but it doesn't feel that warm, Tyler.
It's true February lacrosse out here. We're finally getting a dose of it, and we'll see how the players respond. I think it's a little warmer down here, down there than it is up here, but you know, we can't complain. We get to call a great game here between Blue Hens and the Wildcats, so should be a good one today.
Villanova won last year's meeting 17-9. They lead the all-time series 12-11. They show up today, number 15 in the nation, off to a 2-2 start. Lost their first two games, tough ones at home to Penn State and Yale. Then beat number 4 Maryland, and then last weekend went up to Long Island and beat Hofstra 10-8. Delaware is 3-1 on this young season, beating Monmouth last weekend after that midweek loss at St. Joseph's, with Mount and NJIT their first two wins of this season. So we are just about set for action here in Newark. Villanova, of course, in their road navy blue uniforms, Delaware in those bright home whites. And the face-off X, always important, but last year, without Jay Curvada, the Wildcats won 27 of 30 draws, and that completely dictated the way last year's meeting went between these two. Hervada against the freshman Justin Coppola, and he controls to get us underway this afternoon. This is a Villanova attack that averages just over 11 goals per game.
I'd expect to see a lot of the offense run around this attack unit and then see where they can fill in with the midfield.
Connor Kirst, the big star in the midfield, number 34, feeding low. Keegan Kahn working against Tate Watson, and he swings that one wide to the right of Matt DeLuca. Patrick Daly will put it back in play for Nova. Tyler, how do you assess this Delaware defense so far this season? The numbers are really good, but when you factor in maybe some limited competition, I don't know how, what the context of allowing 5.5 goals per game through four really
is. Yeah, but with such a solid goaltender in there and a veteran unit down low, they have everything figured out. They're just kind of waiting to see what kind of competition they bring in. So should be a good test here today. They're going to see a lot of action down here by this attack, and we'll see how they withstand a lot of this pressure.
Dump it down low, and the first goal of the afternoon belongs to Corey McManus, set up nicely by Keegan Kahn.
So early this season, we've seen a lot of Delaware slow to go pressure. I don't think you're going to see that today. I think you're going to see a lot of quick sliding. And as you see there, they go early, and Nova finds one right over top.
This is number 39, Keegan
Kahn. 8th goal of the year for Corey McManus. 5th assist for Keegan Kahn. And it comes just a little more than a minute into this one.
As you were saying at the beginning, expect the faceoffs to play a huge role in this one as well, just as it did last year.
Coppola, the freshman for Villanova, has kind of overtaken the number one spot on the depth chart. Dan Fisher, Zach Ornstein returning from last year, but Coppola, small, grinding, crafty, has had the most success, so it's kind of his job right now, though we'll see Fisher at times as the Wildcats finally get possession of the second faceoff this afternoon. Zach Kreiza, the long pole, number 12, had it for a while. Now the Wildcats can go on the attack, already with the early 1-0 lead.
They were able to create a 50-50 ground ball there on the faceoff, get it all the way back to their keeper, who made a nice box out play on Kitchen down low and able to get it out.
That is Will Vuitton on the other end for Villanova, their sophomore goaltender. Took over the starting job just about this time last year, then finished in the pipes and coming right back here as a sophomore. Connor Kirst cut off by Owen Grant. That's a good 1v1 matchup there. 81 in white, 34 in blue.
a lot of wing pressure here from Villanova. It doesn't look like they're really trying to initiate much from out top. Everything's coming from these back low corners, just like right there. He turns the corner and puts one low to low.
Khan set up the first goal. He scores the second, and Nova is off and running here in Newark, 2-0 in less than 2.5 minutes. This continues an issue for Delaware. They've had some slow starts to the first four games this year.
Yeah, you can't put yourself in too much of a hole, especially like big-time opponents like they've got going on today. They need to stand firm down there and get a couple stops early. See if Herveda can win one here at the X.
7th of the season for Keegan Khan. Coppola had it for a second.
Looks like he's going to pull a flag out on that.
He got whacked from behind by Jason Sider, and that brings the flag out. And there's the whistle as Delaware gets possession. So already up 2-0. First man up of the game belongs to Nova.
This has also been a problem so far this year for the Hens, is a lot of man down situations. Haven't been the most successful, but it's gotten better of late. So this true test here for DeLuca and Cage. Expect him to see a lot of looks here on this man up.
It is Sider that goes off.
Delaware penalty number 23, Jason Sider pushing.
It's a push on Sider. 32nd man up here for Villanova. Off to somewhat of a slow start in these situations. Just 4 goals and 15 chances. That's 5th best in the Big East.
Making Delaware rotate early, but an unforced turnover is going to bring the ball to the Blue Hens.
That was Daly. Maybe turned too quick towards the cage. Left the pass behind him.
As we have the sun peeking in behind him back there. I'm sure it's a nice sight for the players down there.
Halfway through the 30-man man-down situation. Blue Hens in some trouble. Escape for the moment. Kevin McCormick.
Able to clear. Hens will get their first true possession here.
And we go back to even strength.
I'd like to see where Coach DeLuca tries to attack this Villanova defense from. I don't know if they're going to try to push a lot from the attack, which is their best unit out here, or see if they can get a little downhill run in here from the midfield. And they'll start with Kitchen.
Vatan made his first save, didn't know where it went. Blue Hens back on it.
Robinson with a big ground ball there, tries to spin move to put one high, just missed wide.
So finally some energy on this end for the Blue Hens, spotting Nova 2 quick goals as Ty Kurtz restarts the offense. Kurtz, Kitchen, and Robinson, the freshman. The starting attack again for Delaware. George Ward in the midfield with Clay Miller. And Bryce Reed, 3, 22, and 27. This is Kitchen in his 36-game goal streak. That ball, no one sees it.
About it's 50 bounced. Feet in the air there, and nobody had eyes on it, and except for one Nova defenseman.
It finally rolls over the end line, escorted there by Owen Probilski.
If you're Coach DeLuca, that's not how you wanted your first actual 6-on-6 to play out. Got a couple shots, just not the looks they were trying to get early on.
Probilski running it forward for Villanova. And in the stick of Khan, a goal and an assist already for him. It comes back to Matt Campbell. Colin Crowley, number one, didn't play their last game, had the flu, back to full health today. He, Campbell, and Kirst, the starting midfield for Nova. This is Crowley with some speed. McManus and Campbell. A touch for Kirst with Grant waiting for him. Campbell shooting low and through DeLuca. 3-0 Nova.
Just snuck one by. I don't know if DeLuca wasn't thinking he was shooting there, but he just put one low in that bottom corner there, opposite and away.
And this is a Delaware timeout.
Villanova goal number 2, Matt Campbell, unassisted.
After Campbell makes it 3-0 in just more than 5 minutes. And again, these slow starts have been plaguing Delaware now through all five of their games really this year. I don't know what you do. I don't know if there's tricks you play to make guys start better or what, but you know, today they knew they couldn't get behind early, and here they are.
Sometimes there's just trends to a season, and that might be one of theirs, but as long as they're able to overcome it, with such a high-powered offense and a goalie who stands on his head most of the time, he should keep them in this game, and I expect the offense to get going and kind of take over this game a little bit.
The flip side is, where they've been outscored 7-5 total over four first periods, first quarters, they've outscored teams in the second quarter 20-3. So something about that switch between the first 15 minutes seems to help them.
I don't know if it's jitters or whatnot, sleeping in too late. But I expect them to try and get going here in the first. I don't think they want to spot Nova five goals here in the first quarter, because that's a tough deficit to overcome against the 15th team in the country.
They were down 4-1 after one to Mount, only 2-1 lead over NJIT in their second game, then down 2-0 at St. Joseph's in a game they eventually lost. And then even last weekend against Monmouth, they were down or only up 2-0 before pulling away after the first quarter. And here they are in this 3-0 hole. The sun peaks out again here in Newark.
A sign of things. Hockenberry, the freshman, looks like he's mixing it up in there, makes it a 50-50 ground ball and comes away with it. Exactly what Coach DeLuca was looking for, just switch things up, and that'll get him another possession. We'll see how they respond.
It's just their second chance on offense here in the early going.
It's got to be tough for that attack down there, having two opportunities, and you already spotted Nova three goals. It puts a lot of pressure on them, but we'll see how this veteran attack unit responds.
They're just now getting the six that they want. Grant was up on the offensive end, heads back to defense. Ward steps in from the midfield as Kitchen tries to turn the corner. Here's Ward, number three. It's a Villanova team that brought back all nine of their starters from last year, plus a couple of guys who were out injured that had been starters in the past, so they've got some good continuity, and now they've got another defensive stop here.
A big skip pass over to Robinson. He tried to go low to low. Goalie was able to get down and get on top of it. But a big Delaware ride will bring it right back.
Kurtz picked up the loose ball. Reed in transition.
And that's been one of the great assets of this Delaware team is the riding ability. When they've allowed other teams to get clears out, they haven't given them much opportunity to do so.
Kurtz taking a shoulder there.
Kitchen gets a move, pulls the corner.
Vatan reaching, able to pick that one up before Reed could get to it. Nicely done by the sophomore keeper.
Looks like a deflection out in front caused that one to trickle to the keeper.
And he's way out of his cage, trying to help this clear. Chet Camizio, number 57, his brother TJ graduated last year for Villanova, was in on that defensive stop. He'll cycle back off the field as the offensive middies come out for Nova with Kahn twirling behind the net. Now Crowley tried to go across back post just out of the reach of McManus.
You're up 3-0. I think he's getting a little overzealous with the look there and forces one. Just goes by his guy in the crease. But up three, they're going to be looking for big-time plays like that to extend this lead a little bit.
And that's also McManus's bread and butter. He's a finisher from right on top of the net. Already has one today. Try to sneak him in the backside there. Halfway through the opening quarter here in Newark, and Villanova leads 3-0 on goals by McManus, Kahn, and Campbell.
Looks like Delaware going to try this short stick action at X.